Hi there. Welcome to your dental examination with me today. How are you feeling? Good. Okay. This is just going to be a regular checkup. Nothing at all to worry about, alright? Okay, good. So, how's your general health been since we saw you last? Good. Okay. What about your dental health, especially your mouth and your teeth? Have you had any issues at all? So any sensitivity or areas of pain in particular? Alright. And what about any medication? Have there been any changes to your medication or have you been taking any new medication lately? Okay, good. Right. What can you tell me about your dental hygiene practices in general? How often are you brushing your teeth? Alright. And do you use a manual toothbrush or an electric one? Okay. And what about flossing? Okay. Alright, well, I'm going to start by just putting a mask on here. And some gloves. And I'm going to take a look inside your mouth, if that's okay. The most important thing to me today is that you feel comfortable and safe. So, if at any point you don't feel comfortable at all, just let me know, either by saying so or raising your hand, and we can stop and take a break, alright? Good. I promise you it's nothing that's going to be painful or uncomfortable for you. I'm going to start firstly by just examining your cheeks, your jawline and your lymph nodes down onto your neck. Alright, so if you'd like to keep your mouth closed for me for a moment, I'm just going to start here on your jaw. Good. If you notice any points that feel really tender, just let me know. Okay, just into your chin around here. Good. And just going to hold onto your jaw here, and I'd like you to open your mouth wide for me, please. Good, okay. And close your mouth together. Lovely. And open your mouth wide for me again. Good, and close your teeth tight together. Excellent. Okay, I'm just going to have a look at the lymph nodes on the left side of your head here. Okay. Good, just back up again. And same on the right side. Swelling there or anything abnormal, so that's perfect. So, what I'd like you to do now is just open your mouth nice and wide for me, and I'm going to examine the skin on your cheeks on the inside. Okay, that's it, there we go, nice and wide, lovely, thank you. And brilliant. Okay, so I'm just having a look on this side there for any signs of biting, the biting of the skin of your cheek where it's quite delicate skin. The same on this side, just looking for any sores or any ulcers that you have. No signs of any of that at all, so that's really good, okay? So just again, I'm going to open your mouth nice and wide and your cheeks there. If you could stick your tongue out for me. Good. And say, ah. Excellent. Now, lift your tongue for me to the roof of your mouth. And now to the right side. Great. And over to the left side there. Good. And then down to the bottom again. Excellent. Well done, that's great. Okay. Just take a quick moment for your cheeks there. All comfortable? Lovely. Okay. So next I'm going to look at the teeth themselves. So we'll count how many teeth you've got. So, let's just have a quick look in here. So I'm going to start down on this lower left side of your mouth here. Good. And we have 8 partially erupted, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. And now onto the right upper side here. Okay, so we have 8 partially erupted, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and then we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. Good. All of your teeth in place. So you mentioned that you get a little bit of bleeding sometimes when you're brushing your gums. Which area in particular? Yeah, okay. So I'm going to look more closely at the teeth themselves now, and also your gums, to see how they respond. Okay. If you'd like to open nice and wide for me again. Okay. Working our way around to the left side here. All looks quite good so far. Brushing looks pretty good. Okay. And again, just down onto the left side. Working my way back around towards the front of your mouth. Feeling that wasn't too uncomfortable, I hope. It's all good, isn't it? So, I can see there is a little bit of bleeding there. A little bit of a build-up of plaque, but nothing to be worried about. Your brushing is generally very good. So, I can clean that up for you today, and that should help to relieve that bleeding and help your gums to recover, alright? Good. You mentioned that you are using primarily a manual toothbrush, and that's absolutely fine. Not everybody gets on with an electric toothbrush, and you can achieve perfectly good results with a manual toothbrush, but I'll just demonstrate for you the best practices for using a manual toothbrush. So I have one here, and what you need to do with it is when you're brushing your teeth, just brush very gently. You don't need to apply too much pressure, and hold the toothbrush at a 45 degree angle to your gum line. So just brush gently in small circular motions and start at the back of your mouth, work your way to the front and brush each tooth around that gum line. Then you want to spend about 30 seconds on each quarter of your mouth, and that's then 2 minutes in total. I'll just demonstrate that for you now. Just starting up in the back right corner of your mouth here. So, just hand motions on each tooth around the gum line there. Your teeth nice and healthy, and it should help to reduce any issues with any bleeding that you're having in the gum area. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to remove some of that plaque buildup around your teeth there. So I'm just going to start on your front teeth here. If you feel uncomfortable, okay, or need to take a break. Okay. Your mouth for a moment. Hey. Good. Would you like a sip of water? Are you sure? Alright. Okay, we'll carry on. Then just down on this left side here, this right side, sorry. My left, your right. Great. Okay. Are you right-handed? I can tell just because of the change. Slightly less build-up on the left side here, so you can tell that's your dominant hand. Smaller one here, and this one is more for in between the teeth, so I'm just going to get right into each of those teeth there. Good. Okay, same again, if you need to take a break just let me know. Wisdom teeth that are partially erupted, which is perfectly normal for your age. Have they caused you any issues as they've been coming through? Good, that's great. Some people never notice them as they grow through, but some people they can cause quite a lot of trouble for. Going to put this little suction here just into the corner of your mouth there, okay? Good. Alright, that's just going to sit there. I'm going to rinse your mouth quickly and polish those teeth up a little bit, and that will help then the suction there to remove any of that excess water. Alright. Good, all right. How are you feeling? you mentioned that you aren't flossing every day, but you do floss 2 or 3 times a week. So we would recommend flossing every day, just to remove any food that gets stuck in between your teeth that your toothbrush can't get to. If you struggle with a normal floss, a string floss, which can be quite difficult to use, then you can also use a water flosser. That's what I use at home, and you can use that in the shower, for example. They take a little bit of getting used to, but they're just as effective, and some people find them easier to use as well. Alright, but for today, I'm going to floss for you. So I'll just get some string here. And okay, so let's just work that around our fingers here. And then just work our way into your teeth. Around the top ones there. Good. How's that feeling? Good. Let me just have a look here. Okay. Right. So, that's everything today in terms of the checkup and the cleaning as well. I've removed the plaque buildup that you had in the harder to reach areas, which was probably contributing to your gums bleeding when you were brushing them. So I'm just going to have one final look just around your mouth, okay, and your teeth, just to make sure everything's as it should be. Alright. Good, okay. So we do recommend that you come back to see us every 6 months. I know you're pretty regular with that anyway. But when you pop out to reception there, if you just like to make your next appointment for 6 months' time, and then we'll see you again and see how you're getting on. And we can always talk with you about changing your mouthwash or your toothbrushing, maybe to try the electric toothbrush if you're still having issues with the gum bleeding. When you use mouthwash, when do you tend to use it? Okay. So, we'd actually recommend that you don't use mouthwash directly after you've brushed your teeth. It's better to use it maybe after a meal during the middle of the day, or at least give it a few minutes. Just because once you've brushed your teeth, you have the protection there from the toothpaste. So you don't actually really want to be rinsing your mouth and rinsing all that lovely protection away. That's it, yeah. So mouthwash is good, but maybe not just after you've brushed your teeth. Great. Okay. for me one last time. You again today and to see such well looked after tea. So, as I said, if you'd like to pop back to reception and just make your appointment for a checkup again in 6 months' time, I'll see you then and we can have a look at some options if we need to address any feeding issues in your gums if you're still having them. Alright? Great. Enjoy the rest of your day. See you soon.